It's so good to see you here. Tonight, we are just gonna hang out, and I am going to treat you to a very slow and relaxing hair treatment. So we'll start off with some essential oils and some face mist to settle you in. Do lots of hair brushing, combing, and finger combing. I'll also be doing a long and massaging shampoo and a hydrating hair mask for you. I'll break out some scalp massage tools and we're just gonna vibe, maybe chat a little bit. Before you get too comfy or too sleepy, hook me up with like a thumbs up or a hey, have a good night, one of those sleepy face emojis in the comments below, just to let me know that you were here. Okay? You can watch. You can listen. There's no wrong way. As long as you're relaxing and allowing your mind to settle down from perhaps a long day of work or peopling. Maybe just a long day in general, or a long week. Now is your time to let all of that go and just relax. Got this hydrating and euphoric face and body mist. I really like this. Okay. Let's take some deep breaths together. Deep breaths in. You can hold them if you want to. Long, deep, slow breaths out. Tonight I brought along a couple of essential oils. I have of bergamot. And this is lavender. So I'm going to put just a little bit on my wrists. That's the lavender. It's like a relaxing, warm, slightly spicy. It's just comfy and cozy. I have that on my wrists so that you can kind of breathe it in as we go. The reason why I really like essential oils and face mist, body spray, it's like almost impossible not to just stop. Appreciate the smell. I find that using my sense of smell and pleasing scents help me to re-anchor myself, re-center myself, or set an intention for something that I'm working on. So in the case of our little chill hair session, it's just a gentle reminder to be here and to focus on the experience that we're having now. I've been trying something a little, I guess a little different lately. I've been trying to be nice to myself. Isn't that weird? I think it's weird that we have to consciously try to be kind to ourselves. Like, from a very young age, it's drilled into us over and over again to be kind to others. If you don't have anything nice to say, don't say it at all, is what we've learned. To talking to ourselves, I feel like a lot of us could use a little bit of work on that. I'll often catch myself talking all kinds of shit to myself. Ways that I would never talk to somebody else. Especially not somebody that I cared for. Maybe that's the problem. Maybe there's just been periods of time where I just haven't cared that much about myself and my own feelings. It's not something that I would typically admit out loud. I guess because it's not something that, you know, we really internalize. We don't internalize that we're being mean to ourselves, which is an indicator that we don't care about ourselves. Because if we really cared, empathy for ourselves, we wouldn't be so mean. Maybe we do care for ourselves and we just want better, you know? It's not that we're mad at ourselves, it's just that we're disappointed. But just like you wouldn't scold a child, verbally abuse a puppy, it's not constructive when we do it to ourselves. So that's what I've been working on, is being more mindful about the ways that I treat myself, kind of things that I say to myself, the kind of things that I journal about myself. That doesn't mean that I've let down my standards or changed my expectations. It just means that there's a kind and gentle way to deal with problems conflict there's better ways to redirect ourselves. Just like you would train a puppy or teach a small child, we need to create safe, comfortable, constructive spaces for ourselves to thrive. There's something just so simple and satisfying. I like face mist and essential oils. It's the scent of shampoo. It's also the suds, the foam. The playfulness of it. Also the just simple cleanliness factor of it. I really like really soapy loofahs, too. The little scrubby things that I use in the shower. Like getting them really, really soapy. And just like it's the simple things. One of my favorite smells in the world is probably the smell of a person right after they've taken a shower. You can just smell the soap. Still on their hair, maybe the scent on their skin. I guess it doesn't have to be a pup. I'm thinking about puppies. I guess it doesn't have to be a person though. Because I feel that way about my puppy too. When I give my puppy or my dog a bath, just like I want to hold them and just smell them for the rest of the day. There's something just safe and comfortable about that smell. I know I can't be alone here. I mean, I don't think anybody would argue that it's a bad smell. At least most people wouldn't. But like, how many people out there are like, yes, I know exactly what you're talking about. I really love the smell of clean people too. And for me, it doesn't matter if they're an old person or a young person or what their gender is. It's that, like, just clean, that clean smell. Makes me be like, yeah, I like you. Come sit closer. It's not creepy, is it? It's amazing how many little tangles end up in the hair from a soapy scalp massage. Actually, I have two different hair masks. The first one is salted caramel. Okay. So, it says it's specially formulated, packed with loads of nourishing ingredients. Get your hair back to awesome in no time. No time, really? You gotta let this shit sit for like 10 to 15 minutes. I wouldn't call that no time. It's not too heavy. It's not too light. leave your stressed hair looking just right. Okay. So, salted caramel. Grape gelato. The other one says, what does it say? Treatment and style. This one says tone and shine. But the backs say the exact same thing. Loads of nourishing ingredients. Get your hair back to awesome in no time. And by no time, they mean 10 to 15 minutes. Grape gelato. Or salted caramel. Grape gelato or salted caramel. That's the one I would have picked. So, smells really good. We're going to apply this very gently. And then we're going to comb it. Comb it into the hair. And let it treat for about 10 to 15 minutes. No time at all. Being very careful and gentle, working it into each section of the hair. allowing it to moisturize and hydrate. Bring back that shine. Healthy, balanced. Enriching your hair with vital ingredients to keep it clean looking, healthy and strong. Nutrition that it needs to remain strong and to help damage, rather repair damage, in any areas that might be brittle. washed out. You are thoroughly shampooed and scalp massaged. We're going to dry you off, and I'm going to use some wooden sticks to do a little scalp check, a little bit of scalp scratching. I'm also going to use the wire head massager. That's just so relaxing. Then after that, I'm going to brush you out a little bit more, but this time with different wooden brushes and combs to make sure that by the time we're finished, your hair is silky, smooth, healthy, and rejuvenated. something about this wire massage tool for the scalp that's just, I don't know, it's like, it's magical. If you have never experienced one of these like this, then you probably don't know what you're missing. Especially having it done by another person. It's like the most tingly sensation that I've ever felt. Like, seriously. I'm sure there's other, but it's such a good tingly feeling. And it's like uncontrollable. Almost like if you're super ticklish. It's like as soon as it hits, it's like, a bit unpredictable because of the different lengths. One, two, three, four, five, six, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So this one has 12 wire spokes, and they have little globs of smooth black plastic on the ends so that it gently smooths across your scalp. It's like the combination of unpredictability, that little bit of pressure from the ends, also on the other side there's a blunt pointed end. To apply a different kind of pressure to the scalp, maybe scratching. Maybe just gently moving along the surface of the scalp, not pushing too hard. Just enough to get a little bit of pressure sometimes I'll make little circles. Little circles. You can make zigzags back and forth, back and forth, just very gently. Do it here on the other side. Back and forth. Zigzag. Zigzag. This can be kind of fun to try on other parts of the body. Here, like shoulder, your back. Gently moving it across the skin. There's nothing like just right to the dome. Gets me every time. There's something about something made out of wood. This hairbrush, for example. It just feels good. I can't explain it. Not that, like, a plastic brush feels bad. There's definitely some really good synthetic brushes. There's just something, maybe the energy that the wooden brush has. Maybe that's what we feel. It feels cozy and warm, strong, reliable. Hair can be so unpredictable. Spend all this time brushing it and carefully making sure there's no split ends, no tangles, bumps, flyaways, and then all of a sudden you just hit a tangle and you're like, where'd that come from? Who put you there? And then it takes like a while to comb out. How did that even happen? It's like earbuds, you know, when you put earbuds away. You just put them in a drawer, gently. Lay them down. And then next time you open up the drawer, it looks like a bowl of spaghetti. Like, what happened to these things? I literally just put them in a drawer yesterday. Came back today, and it's like there was a magical creature that snuck in, tied all kinds of knots in my earbuds. Earbuds. I don't like the hassle of charging them. I don't like that I always feel like I'm gonna lose one of them. I don't like it. But I use wireless earbuds. I can deal with it. What I have a hard time dealing with is waking up to see that the magical earbud tangler fairy has visited me in the middle of the night. Now I have to spend 20 minutes detangling these things before I can put them in my ears and listen to music. So I've figured out ways to remember to charge my earbuds. And I figured out ways to not lose my earbuds. Although one time I did wash one of my earbuds accidentally because it got lost in my gym shorts. Probably wondering. Yes, it did still work. Not right away though. It took like 3 days to completely dry. And then my earbud worked again. So what I was saying. I found ways to deal with the wireless earbuds and the things I don't like about them. But in all of my years, I have still never figured out how to store earbuds without the tangle fairy visiting at the most inopportune times, messing up my music listening experience. Another wooden brush. This one has wooden bristles as well. All those tiny wooden bristles with the rounded heads on them so that they're gentle on the scalp. now that you are fully brushed out and shampooed and massaged, I hope that you are incredibly relaxed and that you enjoyed our time together. I hope that you're well and that you continue to do well. And I will see you again hopefully very soon.